Your voice, your opinion, your community. Fact TV, free speech protected.
Some blue eyes. I think blue eyes would look very nice on my bee cookie. Oh, there. I think he's a fine-looking bee, if I do say so myself. Oh, hello there. Welcome to Grandma Kitty's house. And I'm Grandma Kitty, of course. I was just decorating a bee cookie, and I'm not really too creative, but I think he didn't come out too bad. I gave him the black and yellow stripes, of course, and blue wings. I don't know if you ever noticed, but my bees in my bee basket, they always have blue wings. But, oh, did you know, bees may be small, but they are very important little insects. Did you know if it wasn't for bees, we wouldn't have all the beautiful flowers and fruits and vegetables? You know, I for one would really miss the bright, beautiful flowers. And you know, I really like berries and fresh fruit and vegetables in the summer. You know, if we didn't have bees, why we might not have berries and summer squash. We might have to like chew on tree bark or grass. Oh, that doesn't sound very appetizing, does it? No, not at all. You know. Oh, you know, I have a fun story here about a bear and some bees. This is called Bumble Bear Pointing the Way, and it was written by James Hoffman and illustrated by John Sanford. Why don't we read that together? I think you'll enjoy this. Bumble Bear loved honey. Oh, so don't I. The cottage where he lived with his family had shelf upon shelf of honey jars. Oh, there were jars filled with raspberry and strawberry jam, but the honey jars were empty. Bumble Bear usually bumbled his plans to fill those jars with honey. His wife Gwendolyn and his cubs, Wear and Tear, isn't that a funny name for cubs, kindly said nothing. Bumble Bear's stomach always rumbled for honey. Bumble Bear spent hours trying to learn the secrets of getting honey. He buzzed through his drawings and books about bees and hives. Over and over he mumbled, where bees are, honey is. Then one day he looked at the two basic rules on his wall. Where hives are, bees are. And where hives and bees are, honey is. Hives, therefore, are full of honey, thought Bumble Bear. A honey of an idea swarmed into his head. Maybe I can get the bees to move, he shouted, and started planning and drawing and talking to himself. They'll move into my hive, and then I'll have their hive, a beautiful hive full of honey. With a towering stack of plans, Bumble Bear marched into his workshop. Wear and Tear and Gwendolyn Bear heard sawing and hammering and once a great roar. Bumble Bear had fumbled, hitting his paw with the hammer. Ouch, I bet that hurt. At last, the door to the workshop burst open. Bumble Bear marched out with an armful of signs and a crazy hive-like contraption. Down to the metal he went with a new hive and signs. Some of the signs were just pictures in case the bees couldn't read. I don't think bees can really read, do you? But bees are smart, thought Bumble Bear. That's why he had made some signs with words too. And all of them pointed the way to the wonderful new hive. At the end of his trail of signs, Bumble Bear placed the new hive he had made with the last sign, which read, Comb, sweet comb. Isn't that cute? Instead of home, sweet home. He scratched his head as he looked at it. It just doesn't look quite as good as a natural hive, he thought. Oh, maybe that's because a real hive is full of honey. Look, he used a birdhouse and a chunk of cheese and a ham beater and even a plunger. That's pretty funny. Bumble Bear waited by the new hive all day with hopes that the bees would soon arrive. But the bees did not follow the signs. They did not move into their new home. Off in the distance, though, at the old hive, Bumble Bear thought he heard hammering and sawing. The next morning, Bumble Bear looked at his empty new hive. Time for another plan, he said, and taking the wheelbarrow, he headed down to the meadow. Those bees are moving whether they like it or not, he grumbled. Uh-oh, what's he gonna do? Bumble Bear had planned to wheel the bees straight to their new home. When he got to the hive, he wrapped his arms around it and lifted it up. Suddenly, Bumble Bear found himself in a cloud of angry bees. Oh, you should never touch a beehive. Buzzing furiously, the bees formed an arrow, and Bumble Bear took the hint. He started to run in the direction the bees pointed, straight toward the forest. As he hurried and stumbled and ran and tumbled, he noticed the bees had made signs of their own. He followed those signs straight up a tree, tearing his clothes as he climbed higher and higher. Bumbled again, he thought, peering out of the leaves, watching the bees. Later, when the coast was clear, Bumble Bear trudged home in his underwear, grumbling. Wear and Tear and Gwendolyn Bear watched from the cottage windows, not saying a word. That night, Bumble Bear started thinking and studying and planning again. Next time, he mumbled, just wait until next time. Gwendolyn carried a tray of goodies to Bumble Bear as he sat in the cozy living room at Honey Hill Cottage. What a humbled honey he is, she thought. She smiled and said, I have a sweet surprise. Wear and Tear, we're giving a big comb of honey in return for the gift of your homemade hive. The bees will use it for extra storage. Oh, so it worked out well, huh? He got his honey after all. Oh, so today I thought that maybe we could talk about bees. Oh, wait a minute. Not that kind of bees. That's the alphabet bee. That's the A, B, C. Oh, no. That's not the kind of bee I mean. I mean this kind of bee. Isn't he cute? He's a bumblebee, and he's so soft and cuddly and cute and snuggly. And what's that? Bee sting? Oh, yes, you're right. Bees do sting. I need to be careful. You know, bees sting because they're small and we're big and they feel threatened sometimes. And so they sting to protect themselves. Yeah. So, but you know, they have a very important job to do. So we just need to give them a little space and let them do some work. So I thought we could talk about, did you know there are different kinds of bees? I don't mean like wasps and hornets and you know, other kinds of insects. I mean actual bees. There's lots of different kinds of them, and I wasn't aware of that. I have a couple on my sign here. See, this one here is a honeybee, and this one here is a bumblebee. But let me tell you, there are actually 7 families of bees. One is the honeybees, and this is the one I like, of course, because they make honey, and I put honey in my tea every morning. So I really appreciate the honeybees and all that they do. And then the bumblebees, and this is a bumblebee here. They're the ones that are big and round, and they look fuzzy and cuddly, but you can't really cuddle with a bumblebee, but they can sting, but only to protect themselves, of course. And then there's the stingless bee, and I don't know. Does that mean that they don't sting because they're called stingless bees? I'm not really sure. Did you know adults don't always have all the answers? No, there's just too much knowledge out there, and adults just can't possibly know everything. But, oh, look at this one, the mason bee. I have a grandson named Mason. I wonder if they named this one after my grandson. Does he sting? Well, kind of, sometimes. How about this one? Carpenter bees. Now, there are some kinds of bees, I don't know if they're bees, but insects that will actually bore into your house, you know, bore right through the wood in your house to make nests. So maybe they're carpenter bees, and maybe the reason they're called that is because you need a carpenter when they're done with your house. I don't know. Oh, this one's easy. Leaf cutter bee. That's because they cut leaves. It's really quite decorative. They cut these little circles in the leaves. Why do they do that? I assume that they're eating the leaf, but it really is quite interesting the way they cut the leaves. And this one is sweat bees. And oh, I don't know, maybe when they sting you, they make you sweat. I don't know. Like I said, adults do not have all the answers, but that sounds logical. So those are the 7 bee families. And there are actually over 16,000 known species of bees. Wow, that's a lot of bees. I didn't know there were so many. So some of the bees live in hives. Here's my hive right here. What's that? It kind of looks like a bowling ball. I suppose it does, but bowling balls are a little bit rounder so they can roll better. But oh, I see what you mean, because it has a hole in it. Yeah. So bowling balls have holes that you put your fingers in. Mm-hmm. But you do not want to put your finger in that hole there. No, because if you put your finger in that hole, you would find bees swarming around you. No, not swimming, swarming. I mean, that means you would have a cloud of bees around you. And what do bees do to protect themselves? They sting, right. We were having a picnic one time, and my dog was circling the table, and he stepped on a nest in the ground, a ground bee's nest, and they came swarming out, and my husband hollered, run! And we all ran, but my poor daughter got stung 6 times before she finally got away. I actually had to take her to the doctor, What's that? Oh, yes, bees are very creative and they will build nests wherever they can. And sometimes they do have nests down in the ground. So yeah, if you ever find ground bees, you want to be careful where you walk. You don't want to step on them. So bees work well together. Each has a role. See, we have busy as a bee, and each has a role to play. Even though they're small and it's a small role, it's very important for the colony. The colony, that's like, it's not a group of houses. It's a group of bees. It's the group of bees that live in the hive, and they're called a colony. Now, there's three types. Get my fingers together here. Three types of bees that live in the beehive. And one is the male, and he's a real drone. I'm not being rude. I mean, that's what he's really called. He's a drone. The male bee is a drone. And so then there's two types of female bees. One is the queen, and the queen bee is much bigger than the others. But you know something? Her brain is not as big. She has a bigger body, but she has a smaller brain. I think I might want the bigger brain and the smaller body. I don't know. But then the other bees are all worker bees. So if you see a bee out buzzing around flowers, well, that's a worker bee. Most of the bees are worker bees. And they're out collecting nectar to make honey or pollen to feed the colony. So they're very important because they do something called pollination. Pollination is when you transfer pollen from plant to plant, from flower to flower. Now, do you know what happens if that doesn't happen, if the bee doesn't pollinate things? You don't get any fruit or vegetables. Yeah, bees keep the cycle of life turning. Yeah, so I planted summer squash and zucchini this summer, and I apparently don't have any bees at my house because my plants have been producing beautiful flowers all summer long, but then they just fall off and die, and I haven't had one single summer squash or zucchini. I think maybe I need to get myself some bees. Yeah. So bees are very important. Without bees, my goodness, we wouldn't have apples or pears or blueberries or peaches. Oh, I just love all the fruits. Or vegetables. We wouldn't have cucumbers or string beans or tomatoes or broccoli. No. What's that? You could do without the broccoli? Oh. No. Now, come on. Broccoli is very good for you, and it tastes good, too. Those green vegetables are very good for you. So, yeah, try your broccoli. Be really brave. Yeah. So, oh, now here's another thing. Bees also pollinate cotton. Do you know what cotton is used for? Clothing. So, if we didn't have bees, you might be a little bit chilly in the wintertime because you might not have clothes to wear. So, see how important bees are. Bees are very important for our way of life. Yeah. So do you know why bees die? They usually die from burnout. Mm-hmm. They just work themselves to death. Their poor little wings just can't take anymore, and they just can't fly anymore. They'll fly about 500 miles before they finally die. Yeah, they just work themselves right to death, those poor little busy bees. They are hard workers, yeah. But you know, the bee population is declining around the world, and that's because a couple of things. One is loss of habitat, and that's the where they live, the environment where they live, due to, you know, maybe development of cities and buildings and stuff. And then there's exposure to pesticides. Do you know what pesticides are? They're the poison that kills the bugs. Like if you see a bug and you say, "Mom, there's a bug," and she gets a can of bug spray and she sprays it and it kills the bug. Well, that's a pesticide that kills it. But you know, some farmers or other people in other countries or even in America might use a lot of pesticides to protect their crops and things. And the pesticides kill the bugs. And so if the poor bees die off, well, my goodness, they can't do their job, right? And then another thing too is the climate change. But we need our bees, and if our bees die off, well, that shows that our environment isn't as healthy as it should be either, right? So we need to do what we can to help protect our environment and, you know, keep it neat and clean and put trash in the trash and don't overuse and be wasteful and be careful with the pesticides. So there's different kinds of beehives. This is a natural beehives that the bees build and use. This is a more modern kind of beehive that it was designed in 1851 by a reverend named Lorenzo Langstroth, and it's a box. It's got like drawers kind of, and those are like honeycombs, which is where the bees make their honey. So this actually makes it easier for the bees because they don't have to build the hive. They can just use the hive here that's already built, and then the beekeeper can take the drawers out and take the honey out, put it back in, and then their honeycomb is all ready to fill up again. So it actually It makes it easier to produce honey and easier to inspect the hives to make sure there's no disease in there and easier to track the health of the bees to make sure the bees are healthy. Yeah, so, and plus, also it's got like this dead air space in there that insulates them and it keeps them warm during cold weather and cool during hot weather. So it's really very good for the bees. So see the beekeeper, how the beekeeper dresses. He puts on a hat, he puts a net to cover his face and his neck and any bare skin. He's got on gloves and long sleeves and pants and boots. Yeah, the bees get quite used to the beekeeper taking their honey and it doesn't seem to upset them too much, but he has to keep himself covered up just to make sure. So you know, if you're concerned about bees and trying to make sure we have bees in our environment and our community, maybe someday you could be a beekeeper and you could have your own beehive. Mm-hmm. And then you could help protect the bees and make sure they're healthy and take care of them. Yeah, I think that's a very good idea. Plus you could get some honey. I would like to have a beehive just so I can get some honey. I love honey. I use it in my tea every morning. Oh, it is just so good. And it really helps you too, because it you know, it exposes you to all the pollens in your community. So it helps your immunity system too. So all right. So I think that it is time to move on to Move and Groove. I have a new song for us today. Oh, wait a minute. Let me take my scarf off and remind you that when we move and groove, when we get up and get some exercise, it makes our heart happy. So hop up off that couch and let's do our song together. This is a new song, so it takes this one a little while to get started, but let's see what we have here. Ooh, here we go. Kind of sounds like a jungle song, doesn't it? Song. Now, you know, I was thinking, you know, a bee is so tiny and small, you know, and he's just one in millions of bees. Do you think that he wakes up in the morning and he goes, oh, I'm just one tiny little bee. What difference could I possibly make? Nobody pays any attention to me, and I just go out there and do my job, and nobody's even paying any attention to me. I'm just completely overlooked and forgotten and neglected. Do you think that's what the bee says when he wakes up in the morning? No way! That little bee, he wakes up in the morning and he thought, Oh my goodness, I have got a job to do. I've got to go out and gather the nectar and the pollen. And oh, I've got so much work to do. I don't have time to sit around and soak. I am busy and I've got to get to work. Yeah, they are very busy, busy as a bee. Yes, and they don't sit around and think about how they're so tiny and they can't make a difference in the world. They know they have a job to do and they do make a difference in the world, don't they? Even though they're tiny and little and they're just out there doing their thing and no one's paying any attention to them, they make all the difference. Like I said, if they weren't out there doing their job, we wouldn't have fresh fruits and vegetables, and we might have to chew on tree bark. Yuck, yuck. So, okay, let's check our bee bag. So I wanted to show you. So here's the bee on my bee bag. Can you see it there? So it looks like this one here. So it must be a honeybee. So we must have a honeybee on our bee bag. So let's see what we have in here. Oh yes, and remember that our bee bag is the things that we want to be. Okay, so let's see what kind of a bee we have today. Oh my goodness, would you look at this? Be busy. This little bee must have known what we were talking about today. Yes, be busy. Yes, that is a very appropriate bee for us today because we're talking about being busy as a bee. Do you know what happens when you're not busy? When you're not busy, you get bored. Mm-hmm. And when you get bored, you might get restless. And when you get restless, you might get impulsive. And you know what happens when you get impulsive? Oh, you might do something you wish you hadn't done. Mm-hmm. Impulsive means that you do something quick without thinking it through. And if you don't think it through, oh my goodness, you might regret doing it. Mm-hmm. So it's very important to keep ourselves busy. So do you know what we could do to keep ourselves busy? Oh, lots of different things, especially in the summertime. You know, we could go play ball or ride a bike or go swimming. Oh, I've been taking my grandchildren swimming a lot, and they just love to go swimming. So, yeah, you could go swimming. Maybe Dad would take you fishing, or you could always read a book. Grandma Kitty would always encourage you to read a book. Mm-hmm. Reading a book is always good. You could maybe go for a hike or walk. We like to go for hikes around ponds in the summertime and be close to the water. Yeah, that's a fun thing to do. Or you could go to the playground, or you could watch a movie. Maybe Mom would pop you a bowl of popcorn and you could watch a movie. And that's okay. Just don't get caught up with the television and be stuck to the screen all day long. No, that's not good. Or same thing with play games. You could play video games, but same thing. Don't get stuck to the screen all day long and play video games all day long. You've got to get up and move and groove and get some exercise. Yeah, so here's something that's good. You could make Play-Doh. When my kids were younger, we made Play-Doh all the time, and they loved to do that because they would pick out what color they wanted, and we'd make different colored Play-Doh. And the Play-Doh, the homemade Play-Doh, is a lot softer and easier to play with than the store-bought. And you can find that recipe right online, I'm sure. But, oh, we made Play-Doh all the time, and my kids played with it by the hour. I mean, they just loved playing with Play-Doh. And another thing, too, you could make cookies. Mm-hmm. Mom's sugar cookies keep kids very busy for a long time. Mm-hmm. We used to make sugar cookies all the time too, yeah. And we would get different shaped cookie cutters, zoo animals, or different animal shapes, or for the holidays, we'd get the holiday shaped cookie cutters. And oh my goodness, they loved making cookies, and the sugar cookies kept them extra busy. Yeah, they did. You know, when I was, you could play with your toys. Just always make sure you pick them up afterwards because you don't want a messy bedroom. If you leave your toys out on the floor, somebody might step on them and break them or trip over them and fall and get hurt. You don't want that to happen. So you could play with your toys to keep you busy. Mm-hmm. You know, when I was a kid, I would say to my mother, "Mom, I'm bored." And you know what she would say? "Well, you could do the laundry. Or you could do the dishes, or you could sweep the kitchen floor." And you know what I would say? "I'm not that bored, Mom." Isn't that funny? But you know, it's true. You can help Mom with the household chores. I mean, you help get those dishes dirty, right? And you wore those clothes that she has to wash, right? And you probably tracked in some dirt on the kitchen floor. Yeah, so there's nothing wrong with helping Mom with the household chores, you know? And it'll make her feel better. And not only that, if you help her get the chores done quicker, then maybe she'll have more time to take you to the playground or swimming or hiking or something. See? It might be a win-win situation for you. So, all right. Well, you know, I think that's about does it. Did you learn a lot about bees today? I did. I didn't know that there were 7 different families of bees and that they were so important to our environment, but they sure are busy little things, and they are definitely important. And oh, I think one just flew by me. Oh, he's in my flower. Oh, hi there, little bee. Thank you for the honey. I have honey in my tea every morning. I don't know. I think maybe he said you're welcome. He kind of buzzed at me, but I wonder how he got in my house. But what's that? Squish him? Oh, no. We were just talking about how important bees are. I can't squish him. No, he's got a job to do, and I want him to do his job. No, I can't hurt the little bee. I think what I'll do is take my flowers out and put them on the porch, and that way when he flies out, when he's done doing his business, he can just fly away outside and not be in my house. So I think I better do that quickly before he decides to come out and say hello to me again. So I better get that done. So wish me luck. Hopefully I'll get him outside before he comes out of that flower. So I think that about does it for us today. So you take care. You stay healthy, safe, and happy. And Grandma Kitty will see you next time. Bye-bye.